In late 2012, Equal Education was about to take the Minister of Basic Education, Angie Motshekga, to court. She had failed to create norms and standards for school infrastructure and had broken too many promises. But on the eve of our court case, SEE members prepared to march on Bisho. An unexpected call came through from the minister. She said she could not morally defend schools without water, electricity, toilets, classrooms, and libraries. A week later, Minister Motshekga finally agreed to issue binding norms and standards that will apply to the school infrastructure of every school in the country. The case was settled. The road to fixing our schools could begin. Young people across the country celebrated. The minister and EE agreed that the draft norms and standards would be available for public comment from mid-January until the end of March. The minister stuck to this, and the draft is now available. After comments are considered, the final norms and standards will be published and apply from 15 May 2013. So we have forced the minister to draw up a blueprint for our schools. That is a commitment from which she cannot now retreat. But to our shock, the published draft is a betrayal of the hopes of thousands of schools. It just could not be weaker. Now that we've won norms and standards, the struggle is now over their content and quality. Let's take a look at what's in this draft. The draft shows us what, in the minister's mind, makes a school a school. The minister's draft begins at classrooms. Well, there is no direction on size, quantity, and capacity. Apparently, schools will have to choose a library, or a laboratory, or a media center. Electricity is not mentioned. Instead, some form of energy is suggested. Is it okay to have two toilets to 1,000 learners? Yes, according to the draft norms and standards. There is no immediate requirement to fix unsafe structures at risk of collapse. The need for ventilation is completely ignored. No mention is made of internet, phone, fax, or post. Just vague talk of some form of connectivity. And finally, there is no provision for adequate lighting. This looks bad. It sounds bad. It is bad. But it gets worse. There are no dates and targets. And even the little that is required is not binding. The document makes it clear that the minister can take all the time in the world. Minister Motshekga, this is your blueprint. The question is, would you send your child to this school?